It is my people who always first lived in North America before the Vikings first discovered it. A few theories are we crossed a land bridge which was formed between Asia and Alaska during the latest ice age, or we came by boat from the Pacific or Atlantic Ocean. There are many more legends. However, when you first came to our land, did you really think you were in India?
Oops, yes we did. That's why we called you Indians.
Well, you can now call us indigenous people. We have three groups of aboriginals, the Métis and the Inuits of the north, the Métis and the natives.
Gentlemen, and ladies, you are all important explorers. Thanks to you, we seek to find more wonders beyond land and sea. However, I am the greatest Canadian explorer of all. I am Colonel Chris Hadfield, the ultimate explorer. I am out of this world.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The magicians will now entertain us.
I am here to show you some amazing tricks.
I too am a great magician. I'm the great and talented trickster who will wow you with my tricks. For my first trick, I would need a volunteer.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Yes, that means parents, sorry. Or kids. Yeah. Julia, pick parents. Pick parents too.
Yeah. Pick a parent.
Sorry, you don't have to get up and dance. I promise.
That was interesting, but wait till you see my final trick.
Oh, is that the one where you have like the toothpick, and when you try to throw it, it's just you have the tape on your hand, and when you throw it, it looks like...
John kept bowling at people, you just spoiled my whole trick!
Oops.
Oh.
What a wonderful show by the Marvelous Magnificent Majestic Magicians. Sir Christopher Columbus of the 17th century and John Cabot of the 15th century.
Hello, everyone!
Ow! Who are you?
I am the king's evil sister. Of course, you did not invite me.
Hello, sister.
But wait, a gift for the king. A poisonous rose. I shall cast a spell on you. I know you're certainly not 39 years old. You are actually 50 years old. So I'm gonna turn you into a 99-year-old king.
Ugly. 99.
Oh no, what did I do? Mommy's gonna be so mad at me.
Oh, I guess the king can't really say that he's 39 years anymore. He doesn't even look, well, I don't know how old he looks, what he even looks like. And now, I'm pleased to present you once again our service will tell you about the next course.
Next, we will be serving you the finest chicken in the land. We gather the plumpest chickens from the old farmer. A piece of this magnitude demands many chickens at your first cluck. We spent many hours plucking the feathers ourselves.
What do you like to see?
When we were done plucking, we snapped the chickens and placed them on a spit where they roasted over an open fire. Then we seasoned them with the finest spices and the freshest herbs that grew in our gardens. I hope you enjoy.
That was simply delicious. Bravo, Chef Darren.
Of also the 16th century, which one of you lovely guests would like us to reveal your destiny? Reveal through a card. Yes. Pick a card.
Lost it.
Ah, you have picked a wandering gypsy, a woman close to your heart. I also stay away. A woman close to your heart will wander away with a stranger. Make sure she's careful around wagons.
Who would like to see what the crystal ball will bring to them? I would like to choose a volunteer, an adult volunteer. Anyone?
There you go, there's one there.
Okay.
big dragon.
I see you as children. One day you will be happy when they finally move out.
Ah, you have won a trip to congratulations, you have won a trip to Winnipeg.
Where is Winnipeg?
Well, since you asked, Winnipeg is the capital city of Manitoba. In 1870, I founded that province and fought for the rights of the Métis. Vive le Manitoba!
Well, enough fortune telling for today. We must depart. Oh, but wait, a gift for our lovely queen.
Well, we have a long journey and thousands of fortunes to tell. Goodbye and good luck.
Wait!
Oh, thank you. It is so lovely.
Oh, my lady, this is not real gold. Unfortunately, this is Iron Pirate, fool's gold.
Charming bracelet.
Knights, arrest these fortune tellers. They are indeed real pirates who steal golden treasure.
Now, can everyone please verify that they still have their watches and jewelry? Seriously. We are thrilled to introduce to you our Aboriginal storytellers with a fascinating story.
Now I will share what impact the European explorers had on our people when they first came to our land. They brought many germs. Smallpox were the worst. People died by the thousand. Our elders shared us their stories as a way of passing by our beliefs and knowledge from one generation to next.
Also, bison was one of the most important animals to hunt. We used their meat, their hides, and covers for our teepees. We also used bison hair as rope. We also found a use for the bison juju. It fueled our cooking fire.
Did we use bison juju as our cooking fuel?
I hope we didn't. Yuck!
We also used urine as a medication for certain medical problems.
That is absolutely disgusting. I'd rather be dead than have urine on me. Ah!
We also really enjoyed hunting for the Canadian goose.
Yeah, the natives would hunt me for my delicious meat. Use my head for hunting decoy. And use my feathers for arrows. And fluffy down the cozy pillows. My wings as a broom. And my bones for jewelry. Nothing is wasted. Oh no, gotta go.
Thank you. That was...